Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to Silent Running. It's a song by the Mike and Mechanics. And this is a first time single take, honest reaction to it.
Yeah, anything you'd like to say about our channel to the newcomers from all over Asia and Africa and the rest of the world?
Wow, that would be great. So many people covering in one go. That's the beauty of YouTube platform, that you get to go almost every single place. Sitting in your own house. And that's what we do here. We are living in Mumbai, India, making reactions to the music, mainly from the West, but we also react to a lot of music from all over as well. And if you're joining us for the first time here, welcome aboard. This is our first time single take honest reaction to Mike and the Mechanics. When we say first time, we haven't heard the song before. We are going to react to it and listen to it along with you viewing this. As well as we do not pause the music or interrupt the music or our video in the middle of the reaction. So that is how uncut our videos are.
Let's get started on that note. Silent Running by Mike and the Mechanics.
Can you hear me running?
This is a thought-provoking song.
Yeah.
Very deep the lines go. It's fun. It's fun to listen to, but it's got a striking beat as well. Very easy to remember this one. But it's quite deep, the lyrics, and quite on the darker side too.
Mm-hmm.
It seems to be about war.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the results of war. You know, the maybe innocent women and children, civilians basically, who have to hide out, you know, but the soldiers are fast approaching from the enemy lands. And you are caught in the crossfire, maybe you're a village in the middle of it all. And it's time to run and hide, you know, because the enemies are approaching.
Yeah.
And whatever flag they offer and things like that, take it. Don't rise and fight against them. Don't just take it, otherwise you will be killed. The sons and daughters who stand and fight, who rebel. Wow, very thought-provoking indeed.
Yes.
And I hope they heard his call. If it's based on a true story or something like that,
mm-hmm.
hope they heard his call.
Yeah, it sounds like as if this really may have happened. Someone rose up and said, this is what we must do. Because the world is always at war. The entire world, somewhere or the other, is always at war. I don't know when there will be a time when there won't be a war before peace. We have had so many wars and wars and wars. There is a very popular proverb, there is peace after war. But we have had so many. When are we going to have that peace? Eventually, I don't know. So the proverb actually doesn't stand the test of time. It is proven to be incorrect, in other words. After all these years, there is no peace, I think the proverb is wrong, completely wrong. But I like the music, and I like that, can you hear me? It coming again and again and again and again, it makes it haunting and it makes it good. It starts ringing in your mind all the time, the way it was sung. I like those bell-like sounds probably done on the keyboard. This had a little bit of the Genesis sound to it. Considering Mike Rutherford is from there. It's an amazing thing that almost all the Genesis members have had a great solo career as well.
All of them?
I'm not sure all, but the ones that at least I've come across. Steve Hackett, Mike Rutherford, Phil Collins, Peter Gabriel, Tony Banks. And am I missing out someone that I don't know?
Okay, wow, yeah. Interesting. There must be one of the only...
The five members already.
Only bands.
Yeah, you know, one of the
who
only.
Who at right? that level also yeah. have successful solo careers.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is a band as well, right? Mike and
the Mechanics. Yeah.
Mike plus the Mechanics, as is written. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, I guess that's about it for this one. Any... Final thoughts, Kirti. I love the music as well and the vocals.
Mm-hmm.
I like the hook, like you said, can you hear me?
That is done.
Can you hear me calling? Nice.
Actually, it can be played in a different way as well. If you remove the reference of the word, it can be taken as a man-to-woman song as well. Can you hear me calling?
Do you think there's another interpretation? I think I see it just as that.
No,
they are stuck between the war. He's saying don't bother about listening to the church and the
war
system.
What
they
tell
you. Hide in the cellar because the enemy is coming to attack. So I'm not sure if there's any other thing. But do you think there's any other interpretation for this?
I think that makes more
of
sense.
Of course.
That makes more sense.
Yeah, of course, being from India, we may not
have
a
clue. We haven't had cellars.
If it's actually like that. Yeah. No, we don't know if it's about war or it's about a specific thing or what. We don't know. You're just making an educated guess based on the lyrics.
Right.
That's it for this one. We'll come back with another song by Mike and the Mechanics.
Yes.
It's called Get Up.
Yeah.
And we'll be back in 8 seconds or less in the same video.
Namaste YouTube. Welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to Mike and the Mechanics. We are going to react to the song Get Up. This is a first time single take on his reaction to this song. A lot of people in this part of the world, this side of the world, Asia, probably Africa, and so many more parts may not be aware of Mike and the Mechanics. Genesis may be popular almost around UK and some places, but Mike and the Mechanics people wouldn't know. I wouldn't know if I wasn't listening to so much music like now we are doing. So I hope the people who are joining us from all these parts are enjoying these reactions as well as these songs that are selected by our patron Jared.
Yeah, and you can catch many of our reactions on during the Mega Reaction Fest 5 on our other channel. We'll be putting up end screens for it to locate it easily. Videos to those reactions which you may enjoy. You also reacted to Genesis a bit earlier today.
Yeah.
You can catch that reaction too later on. Yeah, let's get started. Mike and the Mechanics, get up. Pretty inspirational.
Yes, it is.
Wow, beautiful. Great tune. Love the keyboard tune. so fast, so peppy. This is a bubbly, energetic tune, very inspiring too.
Yeah.
Wow, what are your thoughts? I love the way he sang it too.
I love the way he sang it, yes. And I like the backup singers doing the get up.
This is more like a pop rock song than
actually,
a rock
song. Yeah. But it had all the elements of rock as well. Yeah. It's a beautiful song. It's a brilliant song. It was all around music with the piano, with the guitars, with the drums and the vocals. Plus it sounds so light and so breezy. And it's an everyday song. It should be for almost all ages too. Especially younger age people who are who are so sensitive towards everything in life or in general other people as well who are not that young. But they are so sensitive towards every change in life or anything that is not favorable coming their way. And they feel hopeless almost every time that it happens. Mm. It's a good song for them. Get up. I like the last two lines when he said, when you're already on your knees, where are you going to fall? Just get up from there and do something. It's a great motivational song. It's an inspirational song. I like the writing of the song. It was written to inspire people, inspire the listeners and the fans of Mike and the Mechanics. And it comes across as that. That loud way of saying get up, each time when it comes out, it actually inspires you. Mm. Isn't it? I like songs like that, that have a meaning, that have a purpose. Not only the music that you can appreciate, but also those words will teach you a thing or two. And that's what this song of Mike and Mechanics is. I remember there was this song, but I don't remember the title. Each time I actually read the title and I somehow forget it. Of the Mike and the Mechanics, probably the first song that we may have reacted. The song about Mike Rutherford and his father. And
yeah,
the time,
living years.
Yeah. Every time I get confused, yeah, it's amazing. It's a beautiful song.
It's a masterpiece.
Song. Yeah. It reminds me of Cats in the Cradle, and then I keep forgetting the name of Living Years. That's how it is. But it's an amazing song, and this one too. I like this a lot.
Yeah, really beautiful. You know, it just tells you get up. You know, it reminds me of Bob Marley's song actually. Get up, stand up.
Yeah.
Stand up for your
that
rights.
That is done differently.
So this is more on the same lines. Get up, do something about it. You know, if things are not working out, if things aren't working the way you wanted to, get up, do something about it. Don't expect someone else to do it for you. You have to do it yourself. Get up and get going. Move forward. Don't stand put. Don't stay put over there. Do something. Take a forward step. And things like that. Very inspiring lyrics.
I don't know why a lot of people get so drowned by what is happening. Or get so low because of other things that are happening around them. As I said, sensitive is the word that I use for them. It happens very often with people that they get so affected. Even though things may not be directly connected to them. It may be their insinuation. It may be their imagination that things are not working in their favor. And they get so immersed into all those problems that they stop living their life. They stop seeing the real life that is in front of them. And it makes it very, very difficult for them to pass through that phase and come out gloriously, come out and do something meaningful there with their life. A lot of people don't understand the life that we have been gifted. We can do so much more in the time that we have on our hands. So many people don't even get as much time as the lucky ones have. Some people die young, some people aren't as gifted as all of us are who have all our organs and all our limbs safe and intact. But it's about how we look at life. The myth of life has been so much that a lot of people till the day they die, they don't understand what life was for them. Life has truly been a myth, and I don't know why not too many people talk about life in general. Why is it a myth to so many people? Why people find it so difficult to live through it? Why people find it such a struggle instead of a beautiful journey?
Yeah, it's thought-provoking indeed. What Kirti is saying as well as the lyrics of this song makes you think about a lot of things. Putting things in perspective is something that you can do through meditation. So, sitting down in silence and just closing your eyes and clearing your mind does give you inner peace. At the same time, it allows you an opportunity to connect with your soul, your inner voice at the same time. Beautiful song. I really enjoyed the way it went. It's peppy, it's upbeat, it's fun to listen to, but at the same time it has a powerful message, especially for those who need it the most at any given point of time.
Yeah.
That's it for this set of reactions. Check out our Patreon page to learn about Kirti and me. And join us for all our reactions on this channel. Our purpose is to create awareness. One of our purposes is to create awareness for music like that in our part of the world, Asia and Africa, where these bands may be relatively unknown. They may not have been heard of. So that is one of our purposes. The other purpose is, of course, to sit here and listen to great music that you request us to do. So that's what we do. Goodbye. Hope you enjoyed your time with us.